Use the part drawing images shown to build this part in SolidWorks. Unit system, millimeters. Part origin, arbitrary. And material, brass. This is the first example for the relations and trimming main video, taking from the CSWA practice test website. If you haven't watched the main 10-minute video lecture yet, or any of the previous examples up to this point, you can find the links to those in the description below. Links to other lectures and examples are also found in the description of this video. By looking at this part drawing, we see that if we create one sketch on the front plane, we can extrude it out to get the entire part completed. Since there are several dimensions and relations noted on the front view, the best way to replicate them without missing any of them is to cross them out as we mark them in our sketch. The origin of our part can be located anywhere, it really doesn't matter. We'll begin by creating a similar outline to the drawing we have. First, with the use of lines, and notice that I'm careful not to click locations that would add unwanted relations slash constraints, for example, a perpendicular constraint, even if a perpendicular relation between these two lines is correct. We then add a circle, and after that, we carefully place some arcs. The one on the top has a center above everything else, starts at the end of the top horizontal segment, and ends when it tangentially touches the diagonal on the top left, so we'll end it a little bit after passing the diagonal's endpoint. The small one on the bottom is tangent to both the horizontal segment and the next arc we'll create, so we leave it close but not touching either. For the last arc, we do know that its center touches the larger diagonal, so we click there for its center, and we know it ends touching the small horizontal segment. And now for the easy part. We copy all the dimensions we see in our drawings using Smart Dimension, and we cross them out as we dimension them in SolidWorks to keep track of what we've added. Things will inevitably shift while doing this, but it's okay. And don't forget to check all views, not just this front view, as dimensions that need to go here might be in other views. For example, this 176 dimension from the top view. Now we add the relations that are explicitly noted in the drawing, particularly the three tangents, and if we need to extend, move, or trim, we do so. Now, if you think about it, the only way a horizontal line is tangent to an arc is for the center of the arc to be on the same horizontal coordinate as the intersection point. So we create that constraint with a vertical relation between those two points. And now we trim all the unnecessary sections of our sketch features. And we're basically done. We extruded 50 mm in either direction, and we assign it a brass material. And maybe even give it a green color appearance so that it looks like what we got. The links to more CSWA type examples, as well as the main 10-minute lectures of the SolidWorks course, are found in the description below, so make sure to check them out. Thanks for watching!